Hi, welcome to Fishkeeping Jamaica. Today, I'll be showing one of two projects in which I'll be doing this here this weekend. The first is my overflow system. Now let's look. I currently have 17 tanks. Of the 17 tanks, 15 of these tanks plumb together, where in which they are filtered and water release, and there's a valve which for each tank releases the water. For example, like this tank, I'm currently changing the water and I'm going to be taking out the fish, put them elsewhere, but in a different type of fish. Each tank has a valve. Now I live in the tropics, and the tropics experience hurricane season between June and November each year. Now at times rain fall very hard, and rain fall very hard, containers like these are filled to the brim. Being it that I rear different type of fish from big to small, I have to take steps so as to prevent my fish from being accidentally overflowed into the yard, in which they will eventually die. And thus I have actually plumbed my 55 gallon drums so as to take the excess water from each container into a specific line, bringing it to the back of the yard. Now let's look. Now each tank has an outflow, right? It has an inflow, and it also have an overflow. This overflow was recently installed. Now what I have done was to actually use 1-inch male and female adapters instead of bulkhead. Usually I would have used 3/4-inch bulkhead, but because of expenses, I choose to use the 1/2-inch. Now it is not yet completed. What I have done, I have used the 1-inch female male adapter. I've actually drilled a hole with a circular saw. I put in one of the adapters through, which is a male, and screened female in it, and so as to ensure that it stays in place, not necessary for water not to come through, to go through, right, but for it to stay in place, I will be putting in 100% silicone, clear silicone around here. Now you notice there's a pipe here. Now in this pipe, look at it very carefully, you'll realize that I have actually used the oxaw blade to actually put grooves in it. This groove serves a purpose. Whenever the water reaches a particular level in the pond, let's say here, and covers here, and just about to flow over, what will happen is that water will go through this groove. Now in going through this groove, the water will actually travel all the way down into this pipe, right? There is no lock off which controls the flow of this water, and it goes to the main, in which it goes to the back of the yard in a trench, in which I'll show you later. So for each tank, this is done. Now this is done with the intention of preserving, or should I say, ensuring that all fish is accounted for, right? All fish is safe in the tank during the case of a hurricane, a tropical storm, tropical depression, or just a heavy downpour. Now the fish in which I actually keep within these tanks ranges from swordtail, guppy, mollies. I have a few tetras, Zeus which is my Oscar, and I also recently just included in my fish stock chromide. And as you all know, chromide, their fries are very fine. And thus I have shown you the last two videos a spawn in which I have in my pond. I had to take out my rainbow and my other chromide, and now it's just a pair, a nuclear family with about average of about 150 fries. Thus I have to be very careful not to actually drill my my overflow holes, because I realized that the last time I drilled, I might have accidentally lost some fish. Now this is what the drilling would have looked like. Yes, I could have used finer drill bit, but at the time it was just not available, and thus I choose to use that inch, right? So presently I am in the mode of putting some goldfish to spawn, thus I'm changing the water, washing out the lilies, and to prepare for that I will show you that in subsequent videos. Now each of my tanks have this overflow. Now the overflow is the marker as to where the water level will maximize, right? Now if you notice, some of the ponds are leaned to one side, which makes it really difficult for the water to actually exit through the overflow. Now what I will do, for example, for this pond, it is lean, it is like off track, right? What I will do, I will release the water in short order, not necessary today, but I will release the water, and in releasing the water, I will actually, after releasing the water, should I say, I will place a piece of board, or probably another piece of stone at the foot, right, ensuring that the tank, the pond, is actually leveled off. Now when it is leveled off, the overflow pipe will actually be sitting at the top of the water. So should in case heavy rain do come, what will happen is that the water will not pass that marker. The water will actually exit, and when it exits through this pipe, right? Just I'm changing the water now, so you see it's exiting, right? And it runs down into a trench in which my yard needs to be cut, yes. And the trench actually goes all the way to the back of my yard, in which it is expected that I plant some fruit trees and such like, so as to ensure that water is not wasted. In the past, I had released the water right at the breadfruit tree, and if you notice, the breadfruit tree is springing very, very beautifully, right? Some amount of water is still released there, from when I actually released the water into that trench. The root actually spread across the trench, so it actually feeds it. Okay, so each tank has its own overflow. It's only one tank in which I have not yet drilled and instituted an overflow, and that's the Zeus tank, which is a black tank to the corner. I have some issues with that, and I will deal with that in short order. Now let me thank you for watching Fish Keeping Jamaica. It is hope that you, in your construction of either your tank or your pond, keep bear in mind that sometimes water can overflow from where it's said to be. For example, you might leave your pond to be, or your tank to be filled, right? And you decide to go in the kitchen, or you decide to do something else meanwhile it's being filled, not remembering that you have actually placed the tank to be filled. Now it is good whenever you have an overflow on your tank, because it prevents disasters, right? For example, when I had the pump installed, which is this pump, right, and the water usually circulates through the canister filter, at times you will see tanks looking like this, right, with water actually decreasing volume within the tank, and you will see tanks overflowing. Now if I had the overflow setup, now this would not have happened, because what will happen is that the water will continuously circulate. Water will continuously circulate. When excess water is in it, it will just leave, and the system will work out, balance off itself. Now with a pond, it's a little bit more easier to actually create overflow, because you have easy accessibility to drill and bit that can drill plastics, or you can build a pipe system within your concrete so as to get the excess water out. But with glass, you would have to carry this to a shop which actually cuts it. So it would be best if you, in planning to build an aquarium, you build it to have, by the way, that's if you're going to be using the whole system wherein water leaves and water exits, water filtrated and exit, it would be good if you have an overflow, because the overflow serve a wonderful purpose. Now, this have taken me quite a while to do, right? It took, believe it or not, this row of tanks, sorry, this row of tanks took me piping off this overflow system. cost me a bit, right? The piping itself was two length of pipe, and each length is 40 feet, right? That ranges for, I think it was $1,000 per feet, right? The fittings, I could not use the normal bulkhead, because one bulkhead was for $200, and I would need at least 15 bulkheads. So you can do the math, 15 times 200, right? The male and the female adapter, the male adapter cost about $25, the female cost $20, right? The bung cost $15, and that was it, and that was less than $100. So therefore, in actually doing my overflow system, I had to consider cost, because I have a large amount of area to be covered. Now that my overflow system is in full operation, the holes in which I have actually drilled within some of the tanks, because it was right, these holes will be filled with 100% white, clear, should I say clear, in silicone, so as to give the fish more space to swim, right? So some will stay, while for example this, it was drilled very high. These holes were for the main purpose of overflow, but I think that the fish was coming up too much to the top, and this allowed babies to actually come out. I think I might just fill them with silicone, right? So these holes will be filled, right? And yeah, so therefore all water will now exit through the overflow, which goes into the piping, which I have actually shown you, into the trench and into the backyard. Thank you again for watching Fish Keeping Jamaica. Do have a wonderful day, and remember to subscribe, share, and like. I like when you press like, it encourages me to move forward and to be creative and to put forward whatever I have actually looked at or become interested in. Bye bye.